Hi friends, today I am discussing how to deploy machine learning model. So I am taking Titanic dataset. I am using random forest classifier. So I have for deployment I am using Gradio. So Gradio is an open source library for deployment of machine learning and deep learning models. What is the advantage of Gradio is you don't need to write a code of HTML or UI2 technologies. There is no requirement of that type of technologies. For deployment, it takes very less time using Gradio. With the help of Gradio, we can share our URL to anyone in the world. We can share to anyone. So firstly, I am installing the Gradio, and these are the importing libraries. So I am doing data processing before. I am doing age, fares, and sex. Why I am taking Titanic data set. It consists of passenger ID, fare, age, sex, survived or. There are so many features. I am only pre-processing age, sex, fare, and sex. Because why I take these three features, these are very important features. And at deployment, I am changing these three features values. Then we can, I am showing how the output will be varied. So for this reason, I am taking these three features. I am doing data processing for these three features. And I am doing the firstly age, and I am replacing null values with -0.5. I am creating bins. After I am doing using cut function. What is the cut function? It sort or segment the data. It accepts only one dimensional data array type formats. It converts our data to into bins. So it will be very useful for unfair also. Cut function for only for numerical data. It can convert categorical data also. So on fares, I am also doing fares function. I am converting fares also, and I'm converting male to female to 0 to 1. I'm mapping. See, cut segmenters or data values into bins. So for this reason, I'm giving bins based upon my wish. You can give your different values. So cut could convert ages to group of age ranges, converts age into different ranges. This is the advantage of cut function. So I am ignoring the importing the warnings and filter warnings ignoring. I am downloading the data, Titanic data. I am transforming these three features because these three features are very important. And this on train. I am converting transform features of train all the features. I am dropping survived passenger ID. Passenger ID is not useful for it. There is no use of this feature. For a survivor, this is the Y and this is the dependent variable. And these are all the independent variables. So I am taking only 80% of data to train and 20% to test. I am using random correct classifier because I am predicting only the person is survived or not. So it is a classification. So I am importing random forest classifier and I am training and predicting. This is the accuracy I am getting. I get 81% accuracy I got. So this is a predict function. I am writing function because to deployment. So I am using this function, predict surveyor. I am taking these three features. With a dictionary type of data, and I am converting this data to these three features because I am, with the help of these three features, I am varying these three features in the UI, but then we can get different results. So return and predicting, I am getting probability. So I am returning precision and survives. So we can get these two outputs. Precision means how many people are died, and survives means how many people are survives. this is the deployment snippet. For sex, I am taking radio g.input.radio function method. So radio means it gives two buttons. We can select these two based upon our requirement. So on the slider, you know, slider can change the slider. This is the slider. We can give values, minimum value, maximum value, and we can give label for age. We can give fair also label, and this is the interface. How the interface will be as per our requirement, we can give. This is the function, which function should be predict. And what are the variables in the UI you need to put, and after launch, then it gives one external URL. You can open this external URL, or it gives inline deployment, inline UI also. You can see this is the inline deployment, and if you press this URL, then external server page will be open. This is the URL. With the help of this URL, you can share this URL to anyone in the world. And this is the output. We can change this. And I'm changing age also. I am changing for C. The output is changed. So this is very advantageous and very useful. And it takes very less time to deploy. So thank you so much for watching my video. And please subscribe my channel.